today we are going to learn about what is group velocity and what is phase velocity. In previous lecture we have learned about what are the Compton effect, what is de Morgulis hypothesis, that particle has dual nature, particle nature as well as wave nature. Okay, so when you consider that about the wave nature, then there is a concept related to the what is the velocity of wave and what is the velocity of the particle. Okay, so if here we have to consider that this is known as your, this is your wave packet. Okay, so according to the quantum mechanics, in the quantum mechanics energy is a wave packet. And what is wave packet? Wave packet is a superposition of a two or more waves. Okay, if y1 is the first wave having this equation y is equals to a sine omega t minus kx, and y2 is equals to a sine omega 2 t minus a2x, here omega 1 t, here k1 t. So when these two individual waves, when these two individual waves interfere with each other, then what is the resultant equation? Y is equals to y1 plus y2. When these two waves inter superimpose with each other, they will produce the wave packet, and this wave packet moves forward with the velocity. That velocity is known as your group velocity. Why it is known as group velocity? Because there are two or more waves. When these two or more waves superimpose, they will form the wave packets. So hence there are two or more waves and it is known as a group, and their velocity is known as your group velocity. And what is phase velocity? Phase velocity is a velocity of a individual component present in the group velocity. So that is phase velocity. Phase velocity means velocity, that is velocity of the individual component in a group of wave, and Vg is known as your velocity, that is the group velocity. Now we will go for the relation for group velocity and relation for the phase velocity. Okay, so here what is the relation for group velocity? Group velocity is equals to d omega by dk. This equation can be written as omega 2 minus omega 1 divided by k2 minus k1. So question arises that how this relation of group velocity comes. Okay, so first of all, if y1 is the first wave having displacement equation y equals to sin omega 1 minus t minus k1x, and y2 is another wave having equation y is equals to a sin omega 2 minus k2x, then these two waves interfere with each other or superimpose, and they produce the wave packet. Then the resultant displacement y is equals to the y1 plus y2. So that is the superposition principle. And if you solve this equation, you will get equation of y is equals to a sin omega 1 t minus k1x plus a sin omega 2 t minus k2 into x. Then again you simplify this equation. So there is a two term. First one is omega 1, second is your omega 2, here k1 and here k2. So what is omega? Omega is your angular frequency. This is equals to your twice pi into n. And what is k? K is your which constant? Propagation constant. Propagation constant, and its values are k1 and k2. So from these two equations, we can define that group velocity is equals to omega 2 minus omega 1 divided by k2 minus k1. So this can be written as d omega by dk. So this is the relation for your group velocity. Okay, So how will you get the relation of d omega by dk? When you consider two waves, first is your y is equals to a sin omega 1 t minus k 1 x. This is the first wave, this is the second wave. When these two waves interfere and forms the wave packet, then you will get the equation for resultant displacement. This is your resultant displacement equation. And from this equation, we will get the expression for group velocity, that group velocity is equals to d omega by dk. Now, next we will go for the phase velocity. Now, what is phase velocity? Phase velocity, so phase velocity. So, what is phase velocity? Phase velocity is a velocity of an individual component of a wave. So, phase velocity is a velocity of a individual wave. It is the velocity of the individual wave. Okay, what is that means? What is the equation of the wave? Y is equals to a sin omega t minus kx. So in phase velocity, phase of a particular point is constant. That is important. So this term is known as your phase. Okay, so what is phase? Omega t minus kx, this phase is your constant. So if you solve this equation, you will get kx is equals to constant plus omega t. Okay, if you it goes that side, constant will come this side, then this will be kx is equals to constant plus omega t. Then if you differentiate this equation, you will get expression that dx by dt is equals to omega by t. Now dx by dt is known as your velocity. So this velocity is your phase velocity. So what is the relation for the phase velocity? Omega by t. Okay, so what we will learn is that group velocity and phase velocity. Phase velocity is individual component present in the group velocity or group of wave or wave packet, and their velocity is omega by t. And group means whenever two or more waves superimpose, then their wave packet is transmitted, that is your group velocity, and it is given by d omega by dt, and phase velocity is given by omega by t. In next lecture, we are going to learn about the what is the relation between group velocity and phase velocity. Okay, thank you.